Falta um pouco mais de 3 minutos.
Pessoas da minha vida parecem sumir, mas insistem em voltar. Amores requebrados, sem pão dormindo, sem no micro-ondas. E o bom e velho gosto de romance antigo é sempre bom recordar. Flores que você traz pra me dar.
Estamos em 53 pessoas na sala. Falta um minuto, pessoal. Fiquem atentos para deixar o martingale pronto, caso seja necessário. Abram nova opção. O dobro do valor. Ajustem o relógio. E fiquem preparados caso precise, mas nós vamos ganhar de primeira. João, João, tu poderia dar uma ajuda para o pessoal lá? O pessoal está dizendo que não está conseguindo entrar na sala. Luísa, Mário. Bom, esse sinal nós ganhamos. Eu vou abrir teu microfone, John, para você poder me ajudar aí. Teu microfone aí já está aberto, tá, John?
Listo, listo, por aqui estou conectado já, Francisco. Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
¿Me escuchas?
Sí.
Ah, porque ahora yo no te escucho, un momento. Ahora se te fue el audio.
Para mí está todo ok.
Háblame, Franciel.
Vou precisar da tua ajuda um pouco aí, John, para
se... A ver, háblame.
Então,
uy, tu puedes creer que se te fue el audio. A ver, ya.
Agora sim?
Sí, ahora sim. Listo.
Eu vou precisar da tua ajuda um pouco aí para se comunicar com o pessoal. Tem um pessoal na sala lá dizendo que não está conseguindo entrar. Mas é só colocar o nome e clicar lá para entrar.
Para que les comente como entrar. Não pode ingressar?
Isso. Tem gente que não está conseguindo ingressar.
Ah, ok. Dá um momentico. Ya está abriendo el WhatsApp web.
Então, o primeiro sinal do dia a gente saiu ganhador, né? Era €1 alto de vendas, 9 horas. Ganhamos de primeira.
Sí, estuvo buenísimo. Buenísimo, buenísimo ese profit. No tuvimos que hacer cardio en la mañana.
Então, esse primeiro sinal, o payout estava 87%. Então, a gente já fez 0,87%. O próximo sinal.
A próxima señal es la
USDCAT. 9,20 venta.
USDCAT va para una venta.
Isso.
Ok.
Ele vem numa tendência baixista.
Vem na tendência baixista, ou seja, queríamos a favor da tendência.
O volume também está vendedor, então nós estamos a favor da tendência e a favor do volume, tá? Esse sinal é às 9h20, falta aí 9 minutos ainda. Eu queria, John, que tu dissesse para eles aí, para todo mundo, que a gente não vai ganhar sempre, mas a gente vai manter o gerenciamento de risco para, no final de um período, no final de um mês, ter uma boa assertividade.
Así es, Franciel nos está comunicando que la idea es hacer un buen gerenciamiento de riesgo, como cualquier negocio o cosa que hagamos en la vida no siempre va a ser positivo, va a haber un momento en que puede haber una pérdida, pero si llevamos un buen gerenciamiento de riesgo, ¿cuál es la idea? Finalizar el mes en profit, en ganancia. Entonces, si hacemos un buen gerenciamiento de riesgo y seguimos lo que él nos indica, las indicaciones del trader, del profesional, vamos a cerrar el mes en ganancia. La idea es porcentajes, no dólares, porcentajes.
Listo.
Entonces, el ingreso es el AUS de CAD a las 9:20, hora Buenos Aires. Vamos para una venta, vamos a ir a favor de la tendencia. Franciel, el 1%, ¿sí?
1%.
El 1%.
A minha banca é 800 aqui, quase, né? Então eu vou entrar com 8. Uhum. Tá?
1%. Va a entrar con 1%. Yo tengo también listo mi 1%. Por aquí, está en digital, bueno, está en digital y en binaria. Yo la elegí en digital, desde ya le podemos ajustar el tiempo a 5 minutos. Y esperamos que faltan tan solo 7 minutos para la entrada.
Eu não sei se o Alex ou o Rafael tá acompanhando a live aí, podiam comentar com o pessoal em inglês lá, que o pessoal tá reclamando do idioma.
Está conectado com os de inglês?
Sim. Eu não hablo espanhol, não hablo inglês.
Yo explique inglés.
Yo hablo portugués y
español.
Italiano.
Italiano. Pero español se le entiende bien.
Sí, comprendo bien.
Camilo, no, el sonido está perfecto. Escucho a Franciel súper bien. Bueno, va a terminar esta vela. Iríamos a la de las 9:20. O sea, falta que termine esta y entraríamos a la siguiente.
¿Va a entrar, Lucas? ¿Vendido? ¿Va a entrar con? ¿Con 5 minutos? ¿GDP? Cinco minutos para o próximo sinal.
Uhum. Muchachos, Franciel les decía hace un momento que los que quieren hacer marketing de atracción con sus prospectos en redes sociales, hagan live con sus celulares en Facebook para que los demás vean, estén atentos del reto, que puedan mirar cómo vamos a llevar esos $100 a $20,000 y pues no, dependiendo también la cantidad con la que hayan querido comenzar cada uno. Entonces traten de ajustar sus celulares para que hagan directo desde sus redes sociales y de así mostrarle a las demás personas, amigos, conocidos, contactos de redes sociales, lo que estamos haciendo todas las mañanas, que es ganando dinero y llevando un buen gerenciamiento de riesgo para y ganancia para llevar $100 a $20,000 en un año. Bueno, estamos ya cerca, estamos a casi 3 minutos y medio de la entrada para el USDK.
Pouco mais de 3 minutos, 2 minutos, 3 aí.
Sessenta e oito conectados na sala.
Vou botar a música, John.
Sim, sim, sim. Pero es que sabe que no entiendo por qué le di a ver. Ahora sí. Estaba sin. Tenía el audio en los audífonos porque no me salía en la barra de sonido, pero ya la ajusté. Me dice si le colocamos el ojo del tigre. Una samba. Oye, ya nos están pidiendo el ojo del tigre. Tranquilos que ahorita si se nos da. Si está cardíaca, le metemos el ojo del tigre. Vamos a irla dejando lista por aquí. Listo, ya sonó el pedacito, ya está lista.
Fiquem todos atentos aí, falta 1 minuto e 1 segundo.
Todos atentos, que já falta 1 minuto e 1 segundo. Recuerden que si ya la tienen en digital, si la tienen digital ya ajustaron el tiempo, si la tienen binaria, faltando 30 segundos le ajustan el tiempo.
Um por cento da banca, configurem o horário.
Un por ciento en el importe y configuren el horario, ya vamos a entrar. 2 segundos o 1 segundo antes. Listo, entramos. Uf, qué salto se pegó ahí inicial.
Quien pegó la tasa lá en cima, mejor ainda.
Al dar el clic, se fue para arriba en un momentico.
No hay problema, Andrew.
Sí, no hizo gap, no hizo salto. Lo que hizo fue un movimiento fuerte, porque el gap es un espacio. Franciela, ¿hay un micrófono abierto? ¿O es el tuyo?
Ya fechei.
Ok. ¿No le pusiste cerrar al entrar? Silenciar micrófonos al entrar. Aquí también va a ser guerra de DJ Franciel versus DJ John.
No es música brasileira, es música gaúcha.
¿De dónde?
Música gaúcha.
Música
do sul do Brasil.
Ah, gaúcha. Ah, ok. Gracias, Viviana, ahí por la corrección. Bueno, está haciendo una fuerte retroceso, pero esos retrocesos me gustan porque siempre tienen que llevar la tendencia, ¿no?
Sí, si ella subir fuerte ahora, John, quiere decir que ella cae fuerte después.
Así como sube fuerte, cae fuerte, dice Francia. Bueno, prepárense para, vayan yendo preparándose para el martingale. Me gusta cuando sube así bastante porque hay muy buen retroceso en la siguiente vela. Eso. Sálgase del monitor, velita. Y nos está marcando los indicadores de la izquierda una también una fuerte venta, ¿no? Un minuto, casi un minuto para terminar. Atentos con el martingale, muchachos. Ajustar tiempo, no opción. Ajustamos tiempo, doblamos.
Ajusten el valor, ajusten el tiempo. Y 2 segundos antes, paso a entrada.
Entra 2 segundos antes. Listo, entramos.
5 minutos más.
Cinco minutos la entrada.
Esperamos sair ganhadores nessa, não precisar fazer o próximo, né, John?
Thank you. De habla inglesa, están pidiendo versión en inglés. Bueno, aún sigue con el alza, pero Isabela tiene que bajar ahorita. Así que pendientes para listar el próximo Gale. Gale, vamos a alisar el Gale.
La senta vio.
Tiempo, 5 minutos, ajustamos. Misma operación, venta. 54, 55, 56, 57, 58. Bueno, ahora sí.
Agora não, não há mais nada para fazer agora. Apenas esperar 5 minutos.
Bueno, ahora sí, muchachos, hacer cardio.
Thank you.
2 minutos más para baixar a velita.
Tres minutos de operación.
Está bem difícil essa, John. O projeto vai começar mais desafiador, John.
Abajo, no te subas. No.
Certo. Então, o projeto vai começar mais desafiador do que antes, John. Infelizmente, tomamos um loss no primeiro dia. O que que acontece? A gente fez 0,9%, né? 0,87% no primeiro sinal positivo. E agora a gente tomou um loss de 7%. Ou seja, a gente inicia o nosso projeto aí com 6% negativo. Tá? Isso é para afirmar, para ver quem vai ter mais coração. Explica para o pessoal aí, John.
Que iniciamos com um menos 6% del gerenciamiento. Negativo, iniciamos menos 6%, pero eso es lo que estábamos hablando al principio. No es la cantidad en dólares, es el porcentaje con el cual vamos a terminar el mes. Entonces, hasta ahora estamos iniciando. De todos modos, Franciel, he visto que normalmente es el 1.5% que vamos a hacer, pero realmente vamos a estar haciendo más del 1.5, porque si las operaciones llevan el 87%, estaríamos hablando de un 170 y casi 74%. Y haciendo un interés compuesto de 1.70, finalizando el mes nos da más porcentaje.
Eu quero mostrar para todo mundo aqui, John, que a gente entrou no sinal totalmente certo, tá? Tava numa tendência baixista, ele tava lateralizado, o momento que a gente entrou, o volume era vendedor, tá? Então a gente entrou como tinha que entrar mesmo, tá? Acontece que o mercado é soberano, infelizmente aconteceu alguma coisa aqui, ó. Diferente de tudo que vinha acontecendo, ó. Vocês podem olhar, ó. Tá? Então isso faz parte, tá? A gente entrou 100% certo, mas o mercado não respeitou.
Assim é. Bueno, Franciel nos disse que íbamos a favor de la tendencia, estava completamente bajista la tendencia. Pero en un momento, ustedes saben que el mercado es soberano y vinieron los compradores y no respetaron la línea de la tendencia que llevaba, que hasta ahí mismo hizo el trazo de tendencia. Y pues sabemos que estos cambios se pueden dar de repente, de un momento a otro. Pero ahí, mira, ahí pueden mirar que viene, sigue los indicadores con una fuerte venta. O sea, seguía la tendencia, pero sabemos que también el mercado los lunes es muy volátil, ¿no? Y hay bastantes toros en el mercado. Entonces, vamos con un menos 6% el día de hoy, pero tranquilos que no se ha perdido nada. Todavía quedan 29 días para finalizar el mes.
Fiquen todos tranquilos, tá? Isso faz parte do jogo. E só está mostrando para nós aqui o quanto a gente tem que ser persistente para sair vencedor.
Así es, que tranquilos, que no se preocupen, esto es parte de lo que estamos haciendo. Y si ustedes manejan la tranquilidad, vamos a salir vencedores al final, porque esa es la idea. Son 365 días, apenas llevamos uno.
Yo deseo a todos ahí un buen inicio de semana, pessoal. ¿Tá? Quien levou o loss no opera más. Tá? Continua nas suas contas demos, apenas quem está dentro do gerenciamento pode continuar operando, tá? Mas a maioria, quem tomou loss, não opera mais.
Que nos desea um feliz início de semana. Si nos fuimos em negativo, tratemos de não operar mais, sigamos o que estamos haciendo, lo que vamos a hacer en el día, y esperemos el día de mañana. Y el de hola, pasado hola. Mañana.
¿Me escuchas?
Sí.
Puedes hablar.
Perfecto. Buenos días. Hey guys, just real quick, this is Alex Payne. I don't know if you guys can see me or not, but I'm just going to record say a few things in English, so you guys that are English speaking, the English speaking language can understand what's going on. So first off, this is our first session. Welcome to our very, very live first session. We had two signals. The first was a win. The second one, unfortunately, was a loss. You know, that's a part of the game, right? So the what we always say, the market is sovereign. For those of you who, like, we are going to be polishing up the structure of these meetings. So we're going to have meetings that's going to be in English only. Some is going to be just Portuguese and Spanish. We'll work it out this week just because it's a brand new everything, brand new program, something that we want to just do it alongside with you. And the other thing is this, for those of you who didn't take this one signal and it was a loss, that means that you can continue on taking the other signals because you should have a personal risk management, which means you have a target, which is 1.5 to 2% a day. That's your stop gain, meaning you hit that goal, you stop, you get out of the market, and you should have a stop loss, which means if you took a loss signal, then you stop it as well. So if you took one that it was the loss, that's your, you know, you don't trade anymore. Now you can switch back to the demo account if you let's say you take either the stop gain or the stop loss, you can switch back to your demo account and continue to practice, okay? Especially the martingale strategy, because you're going in the first time, you analyze the trend line, the support and resistance things that he marked on the screen that you probably didn't see it or don't understand, which is fine. That's the reason why you're on this live session. And then, but once you hit the stop gain or stop loss, you should stop and just switch back to the demo, you know, work it out as far as the practicing the rest of the signals. Now, let me ask you in the chat, how many of you that are only English speaking, just type in the number 10, just so we have an idea of how many people are live with us that only speak English. Type in the box, the number 10. So Sandra is 10. Fly and Chris, Dan, okay, Cheryl, Budge, Bill, Carlos, Henry, Lucy, awesome. So there's quite a few.
Alex.
Oi?
Só deixar claro para todo mundo o quanto anormal é isso que aconteceu agora aqui.
Sim, eu vou falar para ele.
Tá? Você vê que minha lateral... analisar e tal. É totalmente anormal isso.
Eu te mandei uma mensagem lá privada também, depois você dá uma olhada. So guys, okay, great. Tuana said 20 and Brenda here 10. Okay, great. So first off, I know if you, especially if you're in the US, you should be either using pocket option or binary sent, which are the two platforms we're going to use. Can you use the signals for the other platforms? Most likely, like race option. But these are the two platforms that we're going to have people in our team testing and trading in. So because of the graph being the same one, the Forex graph being the same one for all the platforms, then it should be it should be fine. You just have to compare some, you know, if there's a weird platform that you want to teach, test it out, just make sure to contact one of us so we'll take a look at it. As far as pocket option in binary sent, as a rule of thumb, if it's your first time attending a live session, it's your first time even getting exposed to the binary option signals and the service, what we recommend is don't trade for a few days. You know, go through the training, test it out on your demo account. And then one, the very, 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 very important thing, especially with pocket option, is that you do not take the signal if it pays, the payout is less than 80%. That goes for binary sent as well. So 80%, if it's paying out 80%, the payout is 80% or less, do not take the signal, okay? Because if you have to end up doing martingale, which, you know, the martingale, the way it works is you go in and trade with, let's say, 1%. In the martingale, if you lose the first time, you go back in doubling your hand, which is 2%. And then if you lose the second time, you go with the second martingale, which it's 4. So if you ended up losing, you ended up losing 7%. And the payout, it's normally, if you were to win one of those martingale, it basically doesn't cover the initial trade, okay? So what I would recommend is watch the video a few times. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us in the groups with your leader. And we'll do live sessions. I have like my personal Facebook group that we're going to be talking and teaching about Forex and different things and how you can just manage things a little bit better, okay? So, Franciel, tu quer mudar para tua conta de prática? Tem algum sinal agora, não?
Deixa eu dar uma olhada aqui.
Okay. All right, great, great. So guys, so how many of you are using pocket option type number 5? So Bill said, I don't get pocket option layout. We do have, Bill, there is a video under the training session for pocket option, that we do a walkthrough of the entire dashboard. So, you know, you have to watch it a couple of times. We do take a trade there. We use the signal so you can see how it is implemented and everything. But pocket option is very, very simple to use. The only difference, the major difference, is the payout that we don't use payout that is less than 80%.
Alex, okay. Tem o sinal das... Tem o sinal das 9h40. Ele está no primeiro martingale aqui. Tá?
Então, que horas era o payout? Era para baixo?
Era uma venda às 9h40.
Ah, ok. Ok, so Tuana and Brenda said 5. Ok, great, great. So pocket option, like I said, go through the training and watch that video. We'll do live sessions also looking at pocket option. And as in, for anybody using binary sent, type in number 0. Okay, Cheryl is using binary sent, okay, and Jay, Daniela, okay, great. Okay, that's it. It seems like that's a better platform for payouts. Shwana, Okay. Brunel. Okay, great. The same goes for binary sent. Okay, guys. Okay, great. 84%. See, that's the thing. As far as the, when we say pocket option, binary sent, IQ option, these platforms, Monday through Friday, okay, because that's when the market is open for Forex, it should work. The signals should work fine. If there's a minor discrepancy, it's really minor that most of the time it won't affect the trade, okay? The report might affect it, but we'll probably be able to, we will reproduce the results separately. But like, we've had people testing for both platforms and with great success. The main difference with these platforms, again, is the payout. Because if it's paying less than 80%, do not take the signal. We've got, you know, an average of 20 signals a day. So what you should be going for is two winning trades. At 80% is 1.6. Okay, so that's your target for the day. Obviously, if you take a martingale, it's going to diminish that percentage. So you might need to take a third signal if your goal is anywhere from 1.5-2% a day. Okay, so I'm assuming most of you guys are starting out and committed with the 20K challenge, which is starting with $100 and do trades with $1. Okay, that's basically the summary for the challenge. Now, that does not mean that you can't have your own management, and if you want to go for more, and if you have other things. But what I would recommend is, like, if there's a way for you to manage either two accounts or at least have your personal account of keeping track of things, you know, keep track of like your $100 initial, and if you have more money that you want to trade and take more signals, again, use your own risk management, your own personal management as far as, you know, what's your target goal for the day? What's your goal for the day? What's your goal for the gain as well as loss? Okay. How many of you, is it the first time that you are participating, even understand or following these signals for binary option? Type number one. If it's your very, very first time, you've never done it before. Okay, Michael. Yeah, so there's quite a bit of people. Okay, great. That's awesome. Okay, there's so guys, it's the very first day. What we would recommend is stay connected, plugged in, watch the video several times, work, you know, attend any set live sessions you can to get the hang of it, and practice on your demo account. And then we've got a lot of things, really exciting things that we're going to be sharing with you here, that, you know, we're always going to be doing our best to deliver the best product as we can to you guys. Let me explain to you what happened also with the markings that he did on the losing signal, because it's, you know, when you take a winning signal, it's good to study it and see what happened as far as the movement on the candle. But when you take a loss signal, that's when you should really, really study it, okay, and understand at least why you lost, because it's important. You tend to learn more from your losses than your wins. Francel, compartilha a tela quando tinha as marcação lá daquele sinal perdedor. All right, so this, guys, so this is the signal we lost. You see now that there's three candles, red candles. These are, you know, it's called retraction, right? So you have a, let me see if I don't have controls for the Zoom call, but let me see. Ô Franciel, eu queria ver se eu compartilhasse, se pudesse mexer com teu mouse aí. É, tudo bem. All right, so here's what happened. So you see 1, 2, 3, 4 big candles going up, shooting up, okay? The analysis was done correctly. correctly. If you can see the very first one, we were coming, first off, there is a channel there, like the horizontal two lines, horizontal, straight horizontal, not the one on a trend, not like the kind of tilted one, but the one that's straight horizontal. The candles were hitting the up line and the down line and staying contained in that. We call that a channel. So it goes to the top, hits, and then it retracts. Goes to the bottom. They never got to the very bottom. That's a very strong zone. And then retract again, retrace. Went back up and stayed within the middle of the channel. But when you got to the very last one, okay, and that's when we were taking the trade, the signal was for the very the big one there, like after the small little ones, the first big one, that's what happened. So most likely, we don't know, again, the analysis was done correctly. We were taking the signal as a down signal, following the trend that was down. The volume, if you see at the bottom there, there's like some vertical little bars that are red and then goes into the green. But as you can see, everything indicated that was going down. Something happened, and I think it's probably related to some news that, you know, just made that one candle just shoot up like crazy, and then it followed through the second, third, all the way to the fourth. That is an unusual, okay? That's an unusual movement. That's got to be something that happened in the market. So with the graphical analysis, you can literally tell that you don't know exactly what it is, because you obviously we're not looking at the news or anything like that, but obviously you see that something happened in the market, either an announcement or a trade or, you know, something, okay? And then obviously once it shoots up, mantém lá por favor. Once it shoots up all the way up, then the tendency is to retrace. So you got the first, second, and then the small little red candles. And when that shape of candle indicates also a trend reversal. It can happen on the one that we are in now or the next one. Okay, that one, how it closes, is going to indicate if it's going to continue to go up or down. I'm just giving you guys more information than you probably should have now. I just wanted to explain to you guys, so you know, like on the loss, what happened. Okay, the winning trade, it was smooth as it can be. I mean, we won the first time with a lot of room to spare. If you guys were here from the beginning, you saw a big candle. We placed the trade, boom, it shot up, and we won the trade. Shauna said, I didn't see video for binary scent. Is there one anywhere? Shauna, no, not yet. The binary scent, we don't have one, but I will create one and we'll do an overview. But, you know, for in the meantime, since we don't have it yet, please look it up if you want to, right? There's a ton of YouTube videos that you can find just as an overview for the binary scent, but we should have this week binary scent. Says you that we're looking, it's about 80%. Yes. So normally, Sandra, are you talking about the binary scent or the pocket option? Tem mais algum sinal agora de imediato, não?
É, tem às 10 horas da manhã, Alex, mas o dia hoje está bem ruim, tá?
Então, como é que tá o gráfico? Pode botar lá.
Deixa eu ver o que é. Euro Audi Put. É um put aqui, ó, fora da tendência.
Okay.
Para as 10 horas agora.
Ele pegaria na retração, né?
ele rompeu aqui todos os, rompeu as resistências do M15, tá subindo.
Okay, guys, so those of you following the signals, the Euro Odd, Aussie, make sure that we send on the signals. If you go to the signals tab at the very top of the signals, you should see it, you know, the instructions, disclaimers and things like that, because obviously you have control of your money, you have control of your, you know, how much you want to put in, all of that. So some very important things: never ever take a signal against the trend. Okay, what does it mean? As you can see, for this particular signal, we've got Euro Aussie, okay, and the next signal, it's at let's say it's right now, which is 9 o'clock my time, which is like it would be a minute from now, and it's a put, meaning it's going down. But you can see that the trend, you know, the graph or the candles are going up, right? So if you were to take that signal, you would be going against the trend. That means do not take the signal, okay? Do not take the signal. You know, just skip that one and just come back and look at the other signals. Out of 20 signals, which is about the average that we send out, you know, you always should look at those couple of things and then, you know, go with the ones that are in favor of the trend, okay? Claudia, hablamos español hasta ahorita. Yo solamente estoy hablando a las personas en inglés que estuvieron acá desde el principio, pero ya la sesión en español se acabó. Volvemos mañana al mismo horario, más o menos, al mismo horario, para que se quede todo, pero entren en la sala un poquito antes para analizar la señal, okay? So guys, we're ending this session for today. What I would recommend is, again, just review the training material back and forth. There's a few videos there. You know, the first time you do it, it's going to be a little bit weird, but or new, I should say. Watch it a few times. That's, you know, when I first started, it was like watching videos over and over and over, understanding terminologies, understanding what a candle was and how come candle sizes change, the indicators, the time frames and things like that. Although the signals should be a matter of you just looking at the trend, oh, it's going up and the signal is says for me to click to go up. All right, we've got better chances to win that trade because there has been an analysis done, plus we're clicking to go up. If it's the downtrend and the signal is telling you to go up, well, we're going against the trend, so we're not going to take that signal. And sometimes, and here's what you're always going to say, hear us say, not taking a trade is also trading. Not taking not doing a trade is also trading. Okay, staying out of the market, especially, you know, in these, we'll have unusual days. Like for instance, right now, it should be, we would have won that one, I believe. But anyways, it should be, it should be going down, but it's going up. Why? Because with the turmoil that's happening in the market, so you know, a few days out of the week, we'll choose to. I tied, Jay-Z said on JVP. Yeah, so it's because the market today is it's weird. Okay, it's Monday, a lot of things happening with politics and, you know, turmoil that's going on around the world. So it wouldn't be a bad idea to stay out of the market. But again, if you want to take chances in terms of looking at the trend, the signal, studying it a little bit and see, you know, maybe switch to the demo account, take a few trades so you can practice. And then afterwards, you're like, okay, I'm coming back. I'm starting, tomorrow or the next day. It wouldn't be a bad idea as well, okay? So guys, thank you so much. We're going to end this session for today. Like I said, give us this week. The challenge just started today. So if you guys, it's the first time you never heard about the challenge, we're starting a 20K challenge. Basically, the summary of it is start with $100, you know, with a target of 1.5% a day. In a year, you can make 20,000, okay? There are some days, you know, you're going to come out with a losing trade, and there's some days that you're going to come out with more than what you you envision. Like, we have people that are going through the challenge, and I'm pretty much lost, so I need to review. Yes, Sandra, first off, watch the videos, the trainings, 2-3 times, okay? 2-3 times, very important. And second of all, show up to the live sessions. And, you know, if you're completely lost, always go, the great thing about some of these platforms, and for those of you who are using Binary Cent, unfortunately, Binary Cent does not allow you, well, it does if you put a deposit of $500. It allows you to switch to the demo account. So go ahead and use the demo account, always. Practice in the demo account. When you feel a little bit more comfortable, you know, take the signal on the, you know, first the demo account after having several winning trades and you're like, okay, I got it. Then you switch to the real account with real money, okay? Very, very important. Very, very important. All right, so just allow this week for us to iron out a few things, especially of the technical. This new area in the ProTrade Hub is brand new, where we embedded the Zoom calls. It's a great thing that we have the chat here that you guys can participate and, you know, talk to us. We will have sessions only in English, but most of the sessions are not going to be like this one. The first ones are going to be more like, you know, me explaining a few things and talking to you guys through most of the sessions. I don't want to get you guys used to this kind of sessions, okay? The sessions are going to be like the trader opening his screen, marking his line, you watching he does, and then entering the trade, okay? We're not here to teach you how to trade. We are here to increase your chances of winning, and you do the, okay, should I take a trade or not? It's up to you, and however much, okay? So any training is done, it's going to be in the training area recorded. Okay, any questions you can ask, we'll do our best to answer. We'll have sessions outside the ProTrade Hub, you know, leaders that have gone through, you know, some training, additional training. Again, it's not anything advanced because we're not forming traders, okay? We are a signal provider, you know, to increase your chances of winning here, okay? But it's always good to study and to get more understanding, especially on the things that we're doing. All right, great. Thank you so much, guys, for this very, very first live session. Gracias, señores y señores, por estar con nosotros acá en la primera sesión de trading en vivo con el trader. Desafortunadamente, tuvimos un win y uno loss. Pero siguen con las señales porque hay varias señales hoy todavía que puede coger. Solamente tienes que cambiar para la cuenta práctica y practique bastante para que tenga más confianza y seguridad para hacer los trades, okay? So guys, thank you so much. Like I said, it's the very first session that we've done live with the traders. And then again, we have several signals throughout the day that you can still participate. You know, use it in the demo account. If you're taking the trade with your real money, make sure you know what you're doing so you have better chances of winning. Typically, here's the tip. Typically, and you can test that in the demo account. Typically, when you have a loss signal, the next one is generally a win. Or when you have two loss signals in a row, which is unusual, much more unusual is the third one being a loss. Okay, so that's something that you guys can also study if you look at the chart and the results, like, well, we've got two lost trades in a row. The third one, if everything aligns, you know, as far as following the trend can be or can give you more chances of winning, okay? All right, thank you guys so much. Have a great day. Muito obrigado aí, Franciel. Pode finalizar, cara.
Abração aí, todo mundo.
Ah, valeu, cara. Obrigado.